Maga sa inyong lahat, ating po pagninilayan yung sinabi ni Jesus sa Gospel, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith? O bakit kayo natatakot? Wala ba kayong pananalig?" This gives us an idea na the weapon we need to face our fears and insecurities is faith in God. Why faith in God? Because only God is permanent. And because God is permanent, His love for us is unconditional. Because the rest of the material world is impermanent, conditional, and temporary. And if you recognize the cause of our insecurities and fears and worry is because things around us are conditional. Things around us are temporary. They may go. Tomorrow we have, tomorrow we don't. That's why we are insecure. So let us keep in mind God's love. God loves us not because we are worthy of it. Mahal na mahal tayo ng Panginoong Diyos, not because we deserve it. Kasi even we are unworthy and undeserving, according to our estimation, for God's estimation, we remain worthy of His love. Just look at the apostles. They showed lack of faith, but Jesus did not leave them. Hindi sila iniwanan. Hindi sila minaliit. Jesus stayed on the boat. So that's the character of God. He will stay with us, not because we deserve it, but because He is permanent and He is good, and His love for us is unconditional. Ang tanong lang naman po ngayon ay, do we persevere at least to stay with the Lord, especially when our faith is tested and tried like gold set on fire? Kasi naalala ko yung the book I read last April, ang title niya ay Healing. I hope you come across that book. It's a book about faith and healing. One of the best book I read by Francis McNutt, a former Dominican priest. He told about a mother. Yung isang kwento ng nanin, around 60 years old. May dalawa siyang anak na babae. Ngayon, yung isang anak na babae, nagkaroong severe na sakit. Dahil dito, they intensify their prayer to the Lord. And for sure, they expect, syempre, because they storm heaven, they expect a lot that their daughter will be healed. Kaso all the more, nagkasakit yung daughter, nakita ng nanay how her daughter suffered before her eyes and died. At dahil dito, ang kwento ng daughter na isa ay she was so frustrated and disappointed with God. She was disappointed and frustrated not because God did not exist, but para sa kanya, sa nanay, God did not do something and grant their prayers. And later on, she would not like to have anything to do with faith anymore. Di na nagsisimba, di na nagdarasal. She abandoned God. So ito po ang kailangan natin bantayan. Ito ang ating kailangang bantayan din sa ating sarili. Kasi being human, we expect. Then when our expectations did not happen according to how we want things to happen, we will feel frustrated. At ito pong frustration, pag di natin naayos, will turn to pain. Then we will now start to blame. Then we will blame God. So the challenge to us is always to see beyond. That's why faith is very crucial, because faith is the only tool that will help us to see beyond things. It will, kung hindi po natin bantayan, maproseso ating sarili, later on, baka tulad ng nanay na kwento ko, we will also fall disbelieving the existence, the presence of God in our lives. That's why to all of you listening right now, especially those already in the adult mature stage, yung mga nasa around 10 years old, kasi may capacity na silang umintindi ng malalim, develop the capacity to process ourselves. Ano ibig sabihin process ourselves? Ganito ang metaphor niya. Kung sa araw na ito, nagalit ka sa isang tao, kumulo ang dugo mo. Dapat kinaumagahan, nag-start ka na magpalamig. You know how to console yourself. Tulad yan yung naglilis ako ng fish pan. Wala po kasi akong malaking yung balde na para I can transfer the fish at brushan ko yung loob ng fish pan. So, ginagawa ko, sa fish pan mismo, doon ko na binabrush, nilinis ko na lang. Pero I expect the following day, kung araw na ito maitim pa yung tubig, the following day, I expect bumaba na yung dumi, tapos nilinisin ko na siya. So dapat we have the capacity that the next day, we are able to talk to ourselves, process ourselves, allow God, mag-settle down. Kasi if not, if we don't have the capacity to process ourselves, what would happen to us? We have to see beyond situations, see in bigger picture, and look for possibilities and angle that God may have other reasons and plans for us. Kaya po sana, kahit we are in the middle of frustration and disappointments, we do not surrender our faith. Yan po nangyari kay Abraham doon sa first reading. Si Abraham kasi, he lived in a far region of Chaldea, sa malayong lugar. Ngayon, God told him to go to a foreign country in Israel because pag nakapunta siya doon, ibibigay niya ang kanyang inheritance. Land flowing with milk and honey and a generation who is pleasing to the Lord. Eh, comfortable na sana si Abraham sa lugar na iyon. But still, Abraham went. Pumunta pa rin siya. Ang lesson dito, Abraham followed not his own will but God's will. Ang tawag dito ay unwavering faith, unwavering panampalataya na hindi natitinag sa ng takot o kaba o napagdalawang isip. To close his homily, I would like to relate to you the story I heard, the first story I heard sa sermon ng isang pari. I cannot remember my age, but that means very powerful sa akin yung kwento that until now I can remember it. And I believe some of you might have heard it. The story of the boy who stuck in a burning house in the second floor. Di ko alam kung bakit siya naiwanan doon sa second floor. But he was shouting for help. Pero dahil nga the smoke was building up from his part, he cannot anymore see people below him kasi nga, di ba, yung smoke nakukovera na yung mga tao sa baba. But he can hear their voices. Yung tatay niya, nasa baba na pala, sumisigaw, "Anak, ito yung tatay mo. Talon ka na, sasaluhin kita." Sabi naman ng bata, "Tay, tulungan mo ako, pero hindi ko kayo makita." Sabi naman ng tatay, "Huwag kang mag-alala. Dito sa baba, nakikita kita. Though you may not see me, but from below, I can see you." The child jumped and was saved. Bakit pala siya na-save? Why he was saved? Why did he jump? Bakit pala kaya tumalon yung bata? Eh, hindi niya naman nakita kung sino man nasa baba. He is not sure. Para sa akin, he jumped for two reasons. First, he heard his father's voice. Pangalawa, his father assured him, "Nakikita kita dito sa baba." Friends, many times in our darkest time, like depression and despair. What is pala depression? Depression ay because pagod ka na sa dami ng problema, gusto mo na mag-resign. Parang sa trabaho, stress ka na sa boss mo, mababa pa ang sweldo, mag-resign ka na, iwanan mo na ito. Ganun din sa buhay, pag na-depress na isang tao, mag-resign na ako, wala na pakialam sa inyo kaysa mga anak ko, mga asawa ko, bahala na kayo. Yun po ang taong depressed na, resigned na. Kung nag-resign ka sa trabaho, pag ang tao depressed, resign na sa sarili at sa hinaharap. When we are in our darkest time and our heart is filled with hopelessness and meaning, para siyang usok, depression cloud our sight of God. Para yung mga apostoles, because of the wave, their sight of Jesus was clouded already. But the story reminded us, the smoke may cover our sight of God for a while, but God's sight for us and His love for us will remain, because God is powerful. His vision is penetrating. Maybe some of us right now, meron pinagdadaanan, we are insecure of our financial situations, we are having trouble, punuan ang daily needs of our families. Ito yung nabasa ko sa Inquirer, dati, yung making ends meet, punuan yung pang araw-araw, punuan ang toyo, suka. We have difficulty making our ends meet, and seemingly from our human point of view, we cannot anymore see a brighter future ahead. But remind yourself, what you only see and what you see is only limited. Please consider what God sees on your future. God sees a bigger picture, and God sees that you have a future and a destination. So keep the faith always. Kindly write.